Hi guys, it's Michelle. Welcome to my channel, Grateful Creations. Well, I have been messing around with the Colourarte shadow pours again. I've got a 12 by 16 inch gallery wrapped level 2 to be working on this evening. I have my pearl mix, which I will leave the recipe in the description. I have taped, sprayed, pinned, and did my edges on this canvas. The background will be a very neutral background, and then we're going to put some brighter colors on top. We have Amsterdam greenish blue, this is golden thalo turquoise, this is Artist Loft graphite, iridescent graphite. This is Liquitex Bright Aqua Green. This is Amsterdam Yellow Ochre. So let's get started. Now, I did some tests and it yielded 3 different results. So I'm going to go with, which one am I going to go with? It's going to be a crapshoot. We'll see. Whoops. Actually, I'm going to leave a little bit of this edge empty, and I am going to put some of the Colourarte pigments there. Colourarte pigments, we have Firefly. Gorgeous color, love it. This is Autumn Leaf by Colourarte also. This is a Candied Yams. And this is a custom mix. Okay, so, oh shoot, I'll be back. I've gotta get my torch. This quick little torch. This is the Autumn Leaf. Candied Yams. Custom mix down. All right, let's tilt her out. Now these paints, I had made a mistake on when I was mixing them prior with, I mixed them with the Bebr 7300 or 8300. That was wrong because that is a satin enamel. And this satin base, you can't put satin on satin. When you do, you don't get any reaction. Oh, I'm liking this already. So I'm gonna come over to this corner. So I'm gonna let that sit for a minute. Notice how I've got gloves on tonight. These Colourarte pigments kind of stain your hands. So I want to, I'm still trying to get some off from a few days ago. Oh, that's pretty.
I
There's no varnish in this. So, Gac 100 to wet. Liquitex pouring medium. And I put a gel gloss in it. And to thin it out, I used Gac 800. So that's all a look at this. Isn't that great? All right, guys. So I'm kind of liking what I see on this. So what I'm gonna do is I am gonna take some Australian Floetrol. This one I have is Blue Black by Atelier. I'm gonna just do a little bit down here and just to see what kind of reactions I'm gonna get. I'm putting it on my palette knife. It's on the fairly thick side. It's actually, whoops, one that's been around for a while. And I just added a little bit of extra Australian Floetrol. So we're gonna just do a swipe over here. This is one that I did the other day. It was kind of cool. So this is just gonna explode in cells, which I think is kind of a cool effect. These cells are getting monstrously huge. Don't know if I'm gonna do something with those. I think I'm gonna just bring some color into this piece with these paints. So back on time lapse. Okay guys, this is the dried result. I have it outside, but it's super cloudy. It has been raining all day long. But there's a little glimmer of sun coming out. You can see a little bit of the Colourarte pigments coming through here. Very cool. I am so in love with this piece. I love it, love it, love it. What do you think, Ice? Ice, big boy. Anyhow, yeah, I had to show you the dried result.